Good morning, and thank you for tuning in this morning to Behind the Scenes at the Hanover Theater. This is Lisa Condit, and I am incredibly thrilled to be on the phone with Martina McBride, one of the great perks of this job and, of course, this program. Martina is coming for the Martina McBride One Night 2013, Thursday, September 12th, and we cannot wait to have her. Welcome to the program.
Hi.
So, Martina, just a little bit about your background. You know, it's funny, I was reading a little bit about your bio, and I live in a pretty small community, as some people know, but I heard or read that you grew up in a town of 200 people.
That's right, yes.
You know,
roughly 200 people, maybe a little less than that.
Oh, no, they were exaggerating with the 200. Well, I can only imagine how completely special and potentially very supportive that kind of environment was.
Absolutely, yeah.
And so now, you know, where you live, how many people are in the town where you live now?
Well, I live in Nashville, Tennessee, so we have maybe close to 1 million people with all the surrounding areas.
And so did you ever think when you were growing up that you would be going from your hometown to Nashville with such a big, huge difference?
Yeah, well, I hope so. I mean, I've had this dream ever since I was a little girl of singing and performing and just being doing what I do now. So I had hoped that I would eventually make it to Nashville. I knew that's the place where I needed to come to, you know, make my dreams start to come true. And so my husband and I moved here in 1990, and we've been here ever since.
Oh, it's fabulous. And, you know, what an inspiration you are to so many people. I actually saw you perform at one of the Lilith Fair concerts. And I have to tell you, your music is incredibly touching. It makes me cry often. But at the same time, it's really motivational. So do you want to talk about a little bit where you find your inspiration for your music?
Well, you know, I think you find inspiration everywhere. I mean, as an artist, I am constantly looking for inspiration and things to motivate me to create. And so, I mean, I see it in, you know, I have three daughters, so they're a constant source of inspiration. They're all going through different stages in their lives. I've got one that's starting college in a couple of days, and I have one that just started her sophomore year of high school today.
And that's incredible.
A third grader. So I get to see all kinds of different, you know, experiences that they go through. And then I think you just look for inspiration everywhere. I think you have to constantly be open to it.
Absolutely. Well, you have a lot of really great messages for women as far as standing up to abuse. And it's interesting that you mentioned your daughters. I, too, have a daughter who's starting her freshman year of high school. And it is amazing as you watch children, especially girls, develop how outside influences have the potential to kind of chip away at their self-confidence.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. I mean, I think that's, something that we watch a lot of girls go through.
Right. But at the same time, there's a lot of power in your songs. And I see right now that you're currently the spokeswoman for the National Domestic Violence Hotline, as well as for the National Network to End Domestic Violence.
Mm-hmm.
Do you bring all of that to your music as far as some of the, obviously, the lyrics? But there's so much more, right?
Yeah, I mean, I've sang some songs about, struggles that women have children go through. I've just really never set out to intentionally find those songs. They just really, I think, me, and through that, I've been able to, you know, record songs that I feel like have substance and you know, mean something to people. I'm really proud of that.
You should be, and you've certainly won a lot of awards. You've been nominated for a lot of awards. Let's see. You won the Country Music Association Awards Music Video of the Year for Independence Day. It looks like that was your first big win back in 94.
Mm-hmm.
And then Music Video of the Year again for Independence Day by TNN Music City News.
Mm-hmm.
Independence Day, that was a really big song for you. What was it like when you first won your first awards?
It's exciting. You know, I think obviously we don't do what we do for the awards. It's exciting, recognized by your peers and by your fans, that for doing a piece of work that, you know, matters. And so, yeah, I was very excited to win.
And you continue to win awards for being top female vocalist of the year, song of the year, and now you have a relatively newer album. Do you want to talk a little bit about that and what might be different about this new one?
Yeah, well, the album I have out right now is called 11. It's my 11th studio record. And really just the main difference in this record is that I wrote over half of it, wrote over half the songs for the record. So I think it's really personal, maybe a little bit more personal than any other record that I have had, even though I felt like they're all personal. But there's something about when you write your own lyrics and you express your own thoughts that just, I think, gives it a little a glimpse into who you are instead of story songs or songs in third person. You can really just give your fans and people a little bit of a picture of how you are as a person and what you are.
Absolutely. And so we're really looking forward to having you at the Hanover Theater. It's a theater with about 2,300 seats, so it's fairly intimate as far as being able to really experience a great concert like yours. So what can our audience expect when they come to see you?
Probably to a lot of, you know, the hits that we've been fortunate to have over the years, like Independence Day and This Is For the Girls and Broken Wing and In My Daughter's Eyes, Valentine. We do a lot of those, and then we also... we do some cover songs, and we do some songs off of the album 11, and it's just kind of like what I strive for every show is to really make a connection with the audience, and I feel like I love playing theaters and intimate venues because you can really take your time and pace the show at a nice, relaxed pace and really play a lot more music and really get a conversation going, which I love to do, and it's not just about me singing at you, it's about us being together and creating a memory. And so I'm really looking forward to the show.
Oh, and believe me, we are looking forward to you, and you will find a very appreciative, enthusiastic audience, I'm sure. There are some limited tickets left because you are that popular, and people are able to buy tickets at thehanovertheater.org. But, you know, any insights into what some of your favorite parts or songs of the show might be?
Well, like I said, we do a lot of hits, and we do some cover songs that we love to do, and we do some album cuts. And yeah, it was just a good variety of kind of a retrospective of my career and my influences, and it's a lot of fun.
Well, we cannot wait. And so we thank you so much, and we look forward to seeing you again. That's going to be Thursday, September 12th at the Hanover Theater. Tickets are online at thehanovertheater.org. And look for a replay of this interview online on our blog. So, Martina, thank you so much, and we cannot wait to welcome you to Worcester. We'll see you at the theater.
All right. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Myself down to the fair.